Now, as we go through this, what we need to do is we need to kind of set it up so that it's understandable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to set up here the two types called basic and diluted. And as you calculate it, it's what? It's something divided by something to get your earnings per share. So as we look at this, I'm going to start here with my basic earnings per share, which is simple, and that is your basic or your simple earnings per share. That assumes there's nothing potentially dilutive. Then we're going to go on to our diluted earnings per share, which is your complex system, which is anyone who could convert does so. So we're going to go through this and we're going to calculate it. We're going to have this divided by something. So up here, we're going to have the dollars and we're going to divide it by a certain number of shares. Remember in, what was it, stockholders' equity, we did a long task-based simulation and one of the questions asked you to calculate earnings per share or book value per share. So there's something per share, it's dollars divided by something equals dollars. All right, so like dollars over non-dollars equals dollars. So dollars over shares equals dollars per share. That's what we're gonna be trying to calculate. Now, in looking at this, first of all, we start out with your simple or basic. Now, when you do a formula, the top is the numerator, and I'll put that here, numerator. The bottom is down denominator, okay, just in case you didn't know that. Or maybe in your country you don't use that terminology. Numerator top, down denominator. So in a fraction, like 4/2, that's the numerator, that's the denominator, and that equals 2. So numerator, denominator. So as we go through this, the numerator is the top, down denominator. In the numerator, we're gonna start out with our net income. So we have our net income, and that's our total net income minus something. And this minus something is going to be minus preferred dividends. So this is minus the preferred dividends. Why? Because we're trying to figure out the money we have available to give to the common shareholders. Who gets paid first? Preferred. So if preferred gets first, that money's not there for the common. So we're going to take our net income, we're going to have to take out our preferred dividends. But I'm going to put a little A here because I want to note what this A means. What the A says is, with preferred, remember we talked about preferred stock, we said it could be what, cumulative or non-cumulative? Cumulative or non-cumulative. So cumulative means that if you don't declare it, you owe it the next year or the next, when you finally declare a dividend, it accumulates in arrears, where's your rear behind you? So it's old behind dividends, you owe that money eventually. So it's not a liability till it's declared, but if it's not declared, it's cumulative, we still footnote the fact that eventually we're going to owe this. That is called cumulative. Non-cumulative means, hey, if you don't declare this dividend, it is bye-bye-bye lost forever. So let's think about it. If it's cumulative, will you eventually owe it? Yes. So I'm going to take it out. If it's cumulative, you're going to take that out. Cumulative, whether declared or not. So even if it's declared, to declare or not declare, that is the question, right? Remember Shakespeare? To be or not to be, to declare or not to. So even if it's not declared, you still take it out. If it's non-cumulative, only if declared. Why is that? Because if it's non-cumulative, if you don't declare it, it's lost forever. You're never going to owe it. If it's cumulative, but you don't declare it, you're going to eventually owe it. So we're going to take it out. But for how many years? This is an important point. For 1 year only. And the reason I mention that is, let's think about it. If I don't declare a dividend, do I take it out this year? Yes, because it's, let's assume it's cumulative. I don't declare it, it's cumulative. You take it out because it's theoretically as if you paid it. So then next year, we still don't declare it. You take it out for next year's, but not this year, because this year's was already done. So it's 1 year only, this year only, this year only, this year only. Because again, what is earnings per share? It's a theoretical number. Theoretically speaking, if we were to give away all our money to the common shareholders, how much would they get? Well, theoretically speaking, we would have had to pay this cumulative, whether declared or not. Now, if it's non-cumulative, if it's declared, you're going to owe that anyway, so you take it out. If it's non-cumulative, you're eventually going to owe it, so assume it was paid, take it out. What's left goes to common. Does that make sense? I hope so. Okay, so that's the concept. That's what we're looking at so far. So in your notes, you'll see, earnings, net income minus preferred. Since EPS is computed, being computed for common stock, earnings must be reduced by dividends payable to preferred shareholders. If the preferred stock is not cumulative, only dividends actually declared during the year are subtracted. If it is cumulative, the annual dividend preference is subtracted each year, regardless of whether or not it is declared, since the amounts not paid accumulate and will never be payable to common shareholders. Because it doesn't go to common, it's going to go to preferred. The effect of participating, all right, it's more complicated in the exam. So again, that's what they're saying as far as the top or the numerator. That's going to give you the money available to the shareholders. Now, what are we going to divide that with? I'm going to divide that by what I call number one. And this stands for the weighted average number of common stock outstanding.
Huh?
The weighted average number of common stock outstanding. Now, when we talk about the weighted average number of common stock outstanding, that says on average, how many shares were outstanding for the entire year. Now, what that means is actual sales, for example. That would be like stock dividends, stock splits. All of those are included as if they were applied what we call retroactively. So we assume that they happen at the beginning of the year. So if there's a dividend, if there's a split, even if we issued it in July, we assume it happened at the beginning of the year. So that means we assume that they were outstanding the whole year.